encyclopedia. You will find it even different language. If you speak Spanish, sábado means Saturday. You can also find in the Bible, according to Genesis chapter 2, verse 2 to 3, you're going to find out that God created heaven and the earth 6 days, and the seventh day he rested, and that seventh day, it's Saturday. And then Jesus Christ, remember, when Adam and Eve, they sinned, Jesus Christ came to redeem our soul, and he finished his work 6 days, Friday afternoon. Remember, that's why they call it Easter Friday or Good Friday. It says it is finished Friday, and then he rested Saturday, just like he rested Genesis chapter 2, verses 1 to 3. And Sunday, the early day in the morning, you will find in the book of Luke, chapter 24, verses 1 to 3. You will also find in Luke, chapter 23, verses 50 to 56. The seventh day is always Saturday until Constantine, 321, he changed it from Saturday to his own pagan sun, creation, worship day. The devil behind the scene, you are about to see the power God is going to fill us with his outpouring, just like he did it for the first century, the apostle church. And then we're going to go forward and preach the loud cry, the third angel's message. We're going to protest against their pagan sun worship day, means their Sunday worship. And then Jesus Christ will come, just like Bible says, if the day is not short, no flesh will be saved. But for the elect's sake, means those who take a stand, the day will be shortened. Friends, this is a beautiful time in history, because we only one step away from heaven. The mark of the beast, the worship issue in Revelation chapter 13. If you get time, read it, because Revelation chapter 13 verse 12, it's a worship issue, and verse 15, it's a worship issue, and verse 8 is a worship issue. And the Bible helps us to understand that behind the scene, Revelation 13 is the devil. He wants the whole world to worship him. Friends, you have to escape. You have to study your Bible. Christ is calling you, whether you are Christian or not. Whenever you hear Sunday worship in any countries, do not accept it. God is going to protect you. Bible says our bread and water will be sure.
Your Holiness, on behalf of all of us gathered here today, indeed on behalf of all the people of our beloved nation, we welcome you back to America.
When a Catholic Jesuit learns Sunday churches, their doctrine, and the Vatican II, when they infiltrate their churches, and they draw all their churches to so-called the mother of the church, because they know their doctrine and they can answer questions and preach. So the members of the Sunday churches, they think all the pastors are faithful pastors. So now it's all about my pastor says, my pastor says, my pastor says. And this is the crying that a lot of times you hear from them. Instead of them to study, to show thyself approved, just like Bible says, they're making the flesh their right arm. And some of them, when they learn the Sabbath truth, that is always Saturday, because their pastors has been hypnotized them for so many years. So when they go and they talk to their pastors, instead of them to talk to God and make decision based on that says the Lord, they make their pastors make decision for them, because that's how bad they hypnotize them. Friends, don't let the devil use hypnosis preachers, whether it's the pastor or whoever they are, to tell you that you're not going to be holy. You're going to sin until Jesus Christ come. That's doctrines of the devils. When God says, be you holy because I'm holy. When Jesus Christ sets you free, Bible says, ye shall be free indeed. If you think that God is bigger than the devil, then you're going to be holy by the grace of God. But if you think that you're the devil, notice your devil is bigger than God, then the devil's going to make sure that he keep you in darkness. He will keep you to sin until Jesus Christ come, and then you're going to be doomed. Friends, God, his creation power, Genesis, when God said, let there be light, and there was light. So when God said, be, means his creation power, you can be holy, but by the grace of God. This is the old gospel, and now the devil's using hypnosis pastors, all they want is money, riding Mercedes and all kinds of expensive vehicles. They fail to be a Bible Christian. Christ is calling a humble instrument. It's time to take a stand. Forget yourself. Don't look for what's in it for you. It's time to look for what's in it for God. That's how apostles and disciples, they live in the first century. Jesus Christ is coming for the remnant church, means left over. Our character, our lifestyle is going to be like the first century, the church that Jesus Christ set up. Christ is coming. Believe that you're going to be holy. He's going to help you. It depends how you program yourself. If you are watching a Jesuit, Hollywood, worldly program, so-called television program, then the devil's going to use those pagans or infidels to preach you, and you're going to be in darkness until Jesus Christ comes.
No one need say that his case is hopeless, that he can't live the life of a Christian. Ample provision is made by the death of Christ for every soul. Jesus is our ever-present help in time of need. Only call upon him in faith, and he has promised to hear and answer your petitions. Oh, for living active faith. We need it. We must have it, or we shall faint and fail in the day of trial. The darkness that will then rest upon our path must not discourage us or drive us to despair. It is now that we must keep ourselves and our children unspotted from the world. It is now that we must wash our robes of character and make them white in the blood of the Lamb. It is now that we must overcome pride, passion, and spiritual slothfulness. It is now that we must awake and make determined effort for symmetry of character. Today, if you will hear his voice, harden not your hearts. We are in a most trying position, waiting, watching for our Lord's appearing. The world is in darkness. But ye brethren, says Paul, are not in darkness that that day should overtake you. What are you doing, brethren, in the great work of preparation? Those who are uniting with the world are receiving the worldly mold and preparing for the mark of the beast. Those who are distrustful of self, who are humbling themselves before God and purifying their souls by obeying the truth, these are receiving the heavenly mold and preparing for the seal of God in their foreheads. Now is the time to prepare. The seal of God will never be placed upon the forehead of an impure man or woman. It will never be placed upon the forehead of the ambitious, world-loving man or woman. It will never be placed upon the forehead of men or women of false tongues or deceitful hearts. All who receive the seal must be without spot before God, candidates for heaven. Search the scriptures for yourselves, that you may understand the fearful solemnity of the present hour.
Friends, whenever they enforce their sun worship day, Sunday worship, whenever the law is enforced in your country, do not accept it. The mark of the beast in their forehead, symbolic in Revelation, your forehead means your decision. And also when Revelation says their right hand means your action will follow your decision once you accept their sun worship day. When it's an enforced Sunday worship, friends, take a stand. Christ is coming. He loved you so much so that when he was on the cross, Jesus Christ says, I thirst. So whenever you're in temptation, remember when he says, I thirst because of you and I. Order the great controversy. Notice the book, The Great Controversy, because its preparation, it will prepare you by the grace of God.